Hello everyone and welcome to my new video. In this video I want to share with you how you can farm one simulacrum in 3 maps or less. Basically we start here in Lake Sejoris with this map Promenade. You really want this map, not dunes. I tried dunes sucks for me, I don't know why. You want time dilation, this is a really important note. Incursion, monsters in area are at least magic, this is going to give you a lot of splinters. Also time gained from kills is doubled for incursion in areas. That's also really important, we'll talk about that in a bit. The small delirium nodes over here give you extra chance to drop cluster jewels, which can go for a decent amount. You can see right here, a very good amount of chaos. You will drop those. I dropped like 3 minions cluster jewels so far today. They drop like candy if you farm how much I farm. I basically do like 50 of those maps a day. So that's about this. Why Lake Sejoris and not Turn's End? Because my build cannot handle Turn's End delirium farming for some reason. I tried Tropical Island. Where is it? Tropical Island. It's a tier 14. Promenade is 15, and I still cannot manage to do this. Look, I cleared the first half. My build is amazing. A blast through everything. I get to the second half. My build became Queen 69 build. I do zero damage. I don't know why. And for Uncharted Realms 3, you want to use close allies because the bottleneck of this method is basically alpha missions. You want to use this. Maybe you can self-sustain a bit if you are very lucky. This also helps. Secrets of the Stone. Why I don't take this? Because I usually just low investment this. I prepare like 5 maps and run them every like hour or so. You can go for this and drop this node. Because if you use sextants, it's going to add a bunch more density. If you couple that with Beyond, you are going to earn like 200 simulacrum splinters per map, 100%. Because right now I tried with this current setup, without the Secrets of the Stone, I earned 164 simulacrum splinters from one map. That's quite good. So what else you can expect to drop? I don't see the three, where is it, unique jewels. This, you will drop Kitava's techniques from the unique bosses that spawn in delirium, and you are going to get quite a few of those. I got 4 of Kitava's techniques in like 4 days, so one per day. I farm around 30 maps of this per day, so it's quite good. Also, let's talk about this. The following will pause the missed timer. Basically, your delirium won't progress when you are doing this. During an incursion encounter, whenever you enter the Alva temple thingy, so you can really take your time there. Let me show you. As you can see, I enter the temple. I have like 0.9 seconds. This is not good enough. Not a lot of time. I kill a few monsters and it ramps up to like 1 minute. Let's go a bit forward. And as you can see, 1 minute, I have plenty of time to check what rooms I want to unlock, where I want to put the stones, what I want to upgrade, everything like that. And the timer there won't go, like your fog will stay in the place. And that's really good because it will add a lot of value to your maps, since you can do the temple and sell it for even more profit than last time. That's also really good why I pick this node. And here in the end, you can see when the loot explosion will happen, how many splinters I got from this. Let's go a bit forward. And 144 simulacrum splinters. This was not my best run. Basically it was just it was one promenade map, one a metamorph scarab, and the fragments that like this. They are dirty cheap. Actually, you want to put Metamorph on every single map. One Chaos, you always get it back from the Fertile Catalyst and stuff like that. But that's a topic for another video. So 144 was with like 20 Chaos investment per map, which is quite low. So basically I can farm around 1 Simulacrum per 2 maps. So that's like 6 Simulacrums per hour. And 1 Simulacrum, if you check here, is like 110 Chaos. That's already like 6 Exalted Orbs per hour. If you like subtract the cost of that, maybe you make only like 3 or maybe 4 Exalted Orbs per hour just from the Simulacrum alone. That is not counting like the Alva temple that you can make meanwhile, the cluster jewels that you will 100% drop. If you do this method a lot like me, you will drop a few cluster jewels for sure. And it doesn't count the metamorph profits either. Also, why metamorph? And because it adds a lot of density, and I think you get like 20 extra splinters for one chaos plus some other rewards. So that's really, really good. Anyway, guys, that was it for this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you like my content. Definitely abuse this. The prices of simulacrums, I doubt that will go down, and I'll see you in the next one. See ya.